Shoes of the Gospel of Peace by Sidney Bagel. Paul wrote about having shod your feet with the preparation of the Gospel of Peace, Ephesians 6:15. What do shoes have to do with the armor of God? This piece of armor is a mouthful in English, the shoes of the preparation of the Gospel of Peace. Sometimes we shorten it to the shoes of peace or the shoes of the gospel, but the whole phrase is important. Before we can unpack exactly what the preparation of the Gospel of Peace means, let's take a closer look at the shoes themselves. During the time of the Apostle Paul, the shoes worn by the soldiers of the Roman Empire were called callige. They were specifically designed to keep soldiers' feet healthy during the rigors of long forced marches and were very different from the sandals worn by most of the populace. The shoes were constructed from three layers of leather, which were pulled up and laced around the ankle. The callige helped protect against blisters and foot diseases. In addition, small spikes or iron hobnails were often driven into the soles of the shoes in order to give firm footing on uneven terrain.
The Shoes of Peace. The Shoes of Peace is another piece of spiritual armor mentioned in Ephesians 6 verse 15. It is often interpreted as representing the importance of having peace in one's heart and being prepared to share that peace with others. But what does it really mean to put on the shoes of peace? Firstly, the shoes worn by soldiers in ancient times were an essential part of their armor. They provided protection for the feet and allowed the soldiers to move quickly and confidently on the battlefield. In the same way, the shoes of peace represent a readiness to move forward in the spiritual battle with confidence and peace. The shoes of peace are also a symbol of the peace that comes from a right relationship with God. Putting on the shoes of peace is not just about having a sense of inner calm and being able to move forward confidently in the spiritual battle. It is also about actively pursuing peace and reconciliation with others. In Matthew 5, verse 9, Jesus said, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God." We are called to be peacemakers, not just peacekeepers. This means actively seeking to resolve conflicts, promoting understanding, and seeking reconciliation with others. Furthermore, the shoes of peace also represent the readiness to share the gospel of peace with others. In Romans 10, verse 15, it says, "And how can anyone preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news." We are called to be ambassadors of Christ, sharing his message of salvation with others. This means being willing to share the good news of the gospel with those who are lost and in need of salvation. Additionally, the shoes of peace represent the idea of being rooted and grounded in Christ. In Colossians 2, verse 6 to 7, it says, "So then, just as you received Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness." Thank you for watching. On the next part, we look at the shield of faith. God bless you.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment. Perfected Faces, done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and he will surely see it through to the end. He says he makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it is explained today that, "Oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, He is big enough, strong enough, and able enough to secure you and to keep you. You've got to believe that. In the book of Matthew's chapter 6, verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, "You will seek me." And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued, and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it will be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impact a zinga or zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakalayo zizohola. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rat. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. This is the same thing that God says, come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me. Because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, me the same skin taking over. Most things out of focus, you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Cause you're beautiful. Yeah, you're beautiful. Women, them gon' fall in love with you in all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watch and they all adore you.